Hi, I'm Nick Haraz of Creative 111, here with Boris Effects to give you some tips and tricks for working with Sapphire inside of Adobe Premiere Pro. In front of me, I have a Premiere Pro sequence and a clip on the video one track to which I'm going to apply S_glow from the Effects tab. And the reason I have this is because I've installed Sapphire on my system. Immediately, I see that the glow is affecting the brightest pixels in my shot. If I head to my effect controls, I can choose to load a preset where I have up to 20 various results that I'm going to choose. I'm going to choose the Phosphorant Fantasy preset, which I've marked as a favorite to have quicker access the next time that I arrive in my preset browser. I'm going to choose to load that in Premiere Pro. In order to have the glow affect more brighter pixels within the shot, I'm going to play around with the threshold amount and bring it all the way down to its lowest value of 0, noting that 1 would affect no bright pixels within the shot. I'll settle on a final value of 0.2, also choose to increase my brightness to get a brighter glow, and of course start to play around with the color, maybe adding a little bit of yellowness to that glow. Going back to threshold one more time, I'll make an amount of 0.5, and not forget at the very bottom to add a little bit of atmosphere or smokiness to the glow, setting a value of 2 to start, and making sure that I start to play around with the frequency as well as the speed to make sure that the atmosphere is moving at the appropriate pace for my type of scene. Now, don't consider just using glow for footage or shots. Consider using on elements such as text elements that you can create inside of Premiere Pro. Here I have some text that has a black face and a white outline. I'm going to choose to apply S-Glow to the text. Right away, I'm going to make sure that the matte is set to Video 2 or the text itself. I'll choose to increase the brightness to about an amount of 30 so we can start to see it a bit better, and also decrease the threshold to about 0.1. And I can start to see that the glow is obscuring the text. But rest assured, if you go all the way down to the very bottom, you can make sure that the glow happens underneath the text source by setting the parameter to an amount of 1. Last but not least, we'll scroll up, make sure the brightness is down quite a bit to a value of 4, and then maybe start to play with the width red, green, and blue values to have a little bit more variation within our color of our glow. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click the link above to download a free trial of Sapphire and check this out for yourself. Also, follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all the Boris Effects products.